Hi, I am Amanda Klein, and I'm from the Girl Scouts of Eastern Iowa and Western Illinois. We are located right here in the middle of the country. We are right along the Mississippi River with girls on the east and west side of the river. I'm up here in Northern Iowa. We're going to do some bird watching today. I have been out in my backyard watching birds for a while now. Birds can be identified by their shape, their color, their sound, and what they're doing. You can find birds in your neighborhood, in the woods, or at the zoo. You can even watch birds in nature through videos and live streams. Some bird scientists are called ornithologists. They gather all kinds of data or information about birds. They write down all kinds of birds they see. They write down how many they see, and they write down what the birds eat, what the birds do. Bird watchers keep lists of birds too. Many people share their data with others. They might give a presentation or even make a poster. Just like scientists, you can track and share your data with others. One way to do this is with a data table. A data table is a chart. It lists information in rows and columns. Rows go across, and columns go up and down. You can also use tally marks to count how many birds you see. You can count or add your tally marks to find out how many birds you saw and how many of each kind and in all. First, we must decide to go bird watching. It's a lot of fun. Go outside like I am, or have an adult help you find a nature video or live stream with birds online. Then look at the field guide, or have an adult help you to research online to learn about birds you expect to see. Here in Iowa, I expect to see a lot of goldfinches. That's our state bird. We have a lot of them around. Find information about different birds' names, shapes, colors, and songs or calls. If you can find audio for the bird calls, that's great too. I have an app that will listen to bird calls and tell me what bird I'm listening to. Next, set up a data table. Make a grid with three rows, 1, 2, 3, and at least 5 columns. The up and down, I have 5. Now, from top to bottom, in your first column, so that's the first one that goes up and down, write kind of bird, and then tally, and then total. So up here, you're going to write each different kind of bird you see. And if you don't know the name, that's okay. Just write down what it looks like or draw it. Then you're going to make your tally marks. So you're going to make little lines each time you see that bird. Then at the end, we'll total them up. You can add more columns if you need to. Track the number of birds you see. For example, if you see 3 cardinals, write cardinal at the top of the column and make 3 tally marks in the row below. Be very quiet so that you don't miss any birds. Sometimes you'll hear a bird long before you see it. You may never actually see it. That's why I have my app on my phone that listens to bird calls and tells me what it thinks the bird is. Afterward, organize your data. Try to identify any birds you didn't know earlier. You can have an adult help you look online to do this or in a book. Write the total number of each kind of bird in the row below the tally marks. So on my chart, I heard crows. We have a lot of crows. I put 3 tally marks, so that was a total of 3. I saw 4 cardinals, so I put 4 there. I saw a couple of sparrows, and like I thought I would, I saw a whole bunch of goldfinches. When you get to 5, you make the diagonal line. So see, I have 1, 2, 3, 4 straight lines, and then the diagonal, making 5. And then 3 more, 6, 7, 8. So my total is 8. Now, you add up all these numbers. Or, if you need to, write an equation. For instance, 3 plus 4 plus 2 plus 8 is 17. I saw 17 birds while making this chart. Look at your find a data table. How many birds did you see? How many birds of each kind? How many did you see in all? What bird did you see the most often? Which did you see the least? Finally, brainstorm how the bird count would change if the season or location was different. If you live very, very far south, you probably won't see the goldfinches that I did. If you can, show your data to someone else. Tell them about the birds you saw. What was your favorite part about bird watching? What can you learn from watching birds? Would you like to go bird watching again? If you enjoyed this video, please join us or share it with another girl who's not yet a Girl Scout. Thanks for watching and visit girlscouts.org to get more information or to join. Thank you. Bye.